إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وسلم تسليما كثيرا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء، واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام، إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم، ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. أما بعد، فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله. Indeed, the most truthful speech is the book of Allah. وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم. And the best guidance we have is the guidance of our beloved messenger Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. وَشَرُّ الْأُمُورِ مُحْدَثَاتُهَا. And the worst of affairs are those things we newly invent into this religion of ours. وَكُلَّ مُحْدَثَةٍ بِدْعَةٍ. And everything we newly invent into this religion of ours is an innovation. وَكُلَّ بِدْعَةٍ ضَلَالَةٍ. And every innovation is misguidance and it leads astray. وَكُلَّ ضَلَالَةٍ فِي النَّارِ. Every going astray, every misguidance is in hellfire. ثُمَّ أَمَّا بَعْدْ. My dear brothers and sisters in Islam, seeing Allah is a gift that the believers يوم القيامة will be blessed with. And the inhabitants of Jannah, may Allah make us from them, will be blessed with. Jannah is real and Jahannam is real. Yet many times we don't really believe in them because we don't see them. يعني we talk about them, but what is our true belief about them existing already? We see this chair, it's in front of us, we acknowledge it's there. We see the sun on a clear day with no clouds, we acknowledge it's there. We see the moon, like the full moon the last few nights, it's there. But we talk about Jannah and Jahannam. We talk about being able to see the face of Allah, but do we really believe in those things? We act as if seeing Allah in the next life is not a possibility. Or like being in Jannah for eternity is not a possibility. Or that being in Jahannam is not a possibility. Yani it's just words, but is our belief really true to them? Maybe if we really believed in these realities awaiting us, and what we're about to hear in today's khutbah, the angels that encircle those who remember Allah with their wings, we would change our lives, we would change our actions, and we would change how we live this life, really making Allah's pleasure our goal. Look at this narration today and let us reflect upon it so we can change our actions from what they are upon in terms of bad ones to be good ones. To affirm our belief in seeing Allah, our belief that Jannah is already created and Jahannam is already created. عن أبي هريرة رضي الله عنه قال قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم إن لله ملائكة يطوفون في الطرق يلتمسون أهل الذكر فإذا وجدوا قوما يذكرون الله تنادوا هلموا إلى حاجتكم قالوا فيحفونهم بأجنحتهم إلى السماء الدنيا. Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he said in this authentic hadith that is in Bukhari that we're going to break into pieces. He said first, Allah has some angels who look for those who celebrate the praises of Allah, study the deen of Allah, study the book of Allah, remember Allah. This isn't in the bid'ah type of ways of getting together to do dhikr out loud or with beads or stones. We're talking about remembering Allah, studying His deen, glorifying and praising Him the way He deserves. They go around looking for them on the roads and on the paths, and when they find some of those people celebrating the praises of Allah, they call each other, other angels, come over here, to the object of your pursuit. He added then the angels, they encircle them with their wings, up to the skies of the world. So the angels, our iman should be of them, that they encircle with their wings, yani up to the skies of the world, those who are remembering Allah and studying His deen, going to the halaqat, to the lessons that are given to further know your deen. The hadith continues, قَالَ فَيَسْأَلُهُمْ رَبُّهُمْ وَهُوَ أَعْلَمُ مِنْهُمْ مَا يَقُولُ عِبَادِي قالوا يقولون يسبحونك ويكبرونك ويحمدونك ويمجدونك قال فيقول هل رأوني قال فيقولون لا والله ما رأوك قال فيقول وكيف لو رأوني قال يقولون لو رأوك كانوا أشد لك عبادة وأشد لك تمجيدا وأكثر لك تسبيحا. Prophet Muhammad ﷺ, he then said, after those people who celebrate the praises of Allah, the angels, they go back to their Lord, they go back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Allah asks those angels, although Allah knows better than them already, but He asks them. He said, what do my slaves say? What are my slaves on the earth saying? So the angels reply, they say, Subhanallah, and Allahu Akbar, and Alhamdulillah. They glorify and praise you. Allah says, they're doing this, did they see me? They say, Wallahi, la ya Rabbi, our Lord, Wallahi, by Allah, no, they did not see you. Allah says, how would they have been if they saw me? How would they be living their life if they saw you? The angels reply, if they saw you, they would worship you more devoutly. They would celebrate your glory more deeply. They would declare your freedom from any resemblance to anything more often. My dear brothers and sisters in Islam, this reminds us of a call that the people of Jannah will be called to when they're in Jannah, and we'll be hearing some description of it shortly. When they're in Jannah thinking they've made it, they're on cloud nine, and a call calls out from the heavens saying, أَيْنَ عِبَادِ الَّذِينَ أَطَعُونِي بِالْغَيْبِ وَلَمْ يَرَوْنِي. A call from the heavens goes out from Allah saying, where are my servants who obeyed me, who worshipped me, who prayed to me, who fasted for me, who gave sadaqah for me to be pleased with him or her? Where are they? Calling them, أَيْنَ عِبَادِ الَّذِينَ أَطَعُونِي بِالْغَيْبِ. They did this without seeing me. So they'll be called to that special meeting with Allah to see the face of Allah. عن أبي هريرة رضي الله عنه قال قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم سبق المفردون قالوا وما المفردون يا رسول الله يا رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم قال الذاكرون الله كثيرا والذاكرات رواه مسلم. Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, the mufarradun have gone ahead. They're beating you in the race. They're way ahead of you in the race. So the companions, they said, who are the mufarradun, the Messenger of Allah? So the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, the mufarradun are the men and the women who remember Allah, Allah, Allah. They're constantly remembering Allah. When they're alone, they're constantly going to learn the religion of Allah, to study the Quran, to study the Ahadith, to hear what they should be upon so they're successful in this life and the next. These are the Mufarradun. Abu Malik al-Ash'ari radiallahu anhu, he said that the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, Alhamdulillahi tamla'u al-nizamu subhanallahi walhamdulillahi tamlan aw tamla'u ma bayna as-samawati wal-ard. Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the authentic hadith in the Sunnah of al-Tirmidhi, he said, Alhamdulillah, that phrase just that you utter it with your lips, it will fill your scales. Those scales, the mizan, that come out on the day of judgment, on the day of resurrection, that will weigh our deeds. The scale can be filled by you just praising and glorifying Allah through the easy times and through the struggles. And subhanAllah and alhamdulillah, those phrases are so deep, so meaningful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that the one who says it, it's like those phrases fill the heavens and the earth. This is just for remembering Allah. In the hadith of Jibreel, we see that he asked, when he came to the Prophet in the form of a man, he told the Prophet, فَأَخْبِرْنِي عَنِ الْإِحْسَانِ. And if you've been coming to the halakas on Sundays, we were in depth analyzing Islam, Iman, and Ihsan, because you need to know those three to have knowledge of your deen so you can say deen of Islam when you're questioned in the grave. He said, فَأَخْبِرْنِي عَنِ الْإِحْسَانِ. Tell me what is الْإِحْسَانِ. Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, أَن تَعْبُدَ اللَّهَ كَأَنَّكَ تَرَاهُ فَإِنْ لَمْ تَكُنْ تَرَاهُ فَهُوَ يَرَاكَ. He said, it is that you worship Allah as if you see Him. But knowing that you cannot see him, know that he sees you. This is a high level. A high level. Past even the level of iman, having knowledge of iman, that you gain this level of ihsan. Worshipping Allah as if you see him physically in front of you, but knowing that you can't, you know that he sees you. Allah, he said, لَلَّذِينَ أَحْسَنُوا الْحُسْنَ وَزِيَادَ. For those who do good, for those who believe, there will be the best, the reward of Jannah. And then الزِيَادَ, even more so, being able to look at the face of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. لَهُمْ مَا يَشَاءُونَ فِيهَا وَلَدَيْنَا مَزِيدٌ. Allah says, there they will have all that they desire, and we have more for them. Again, an ayah referring to the fact that you will be able to glance and look at the face of your Lord. وَجُوهُمْ يَوْمَئِذٍ نَاظِرًا إِلَىٰ رَبِّهَا نَاظِرًا. Allah saying in the Quran what means that they, the faces, will be beaming, shining, radiant, looking at the face of their Lord, only for the believers on the day of resurrection. Everyone else will be shielded and not be able to see Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala on that day. Worship Allah, glorify Him, praise Him, keep your tongue wet with the remembrance of Allah. Because even though you don't see Him, this will gain you great reward, Yawm al-Qiyamah. Then the hadith continued, where Prophet Muhammad said that Allah will then say, قَالَ يَقُولُ فَمَا سَأَلُونِي قَالَ يَسْأَلُونَكَ الْجَنَّةِ قَالَ يَقُولُ وَهَلْ رَأَوْهَا قَالَ يَقُولُونَ لَا وَاللَّهِ يَا رَبِّي مَا رَأَوْهَا قَالَ يَقُولُ فَكَيْفَ لَوْ أَنَّهُمْ رَأَوْهَا قَالَ يَقُولُونَ لَوْ أَنَّهُمْ رَأَوْهَا كَانُوا أَشَدَّ عَلَيْهَا حِرْسًا وَأَشَدَّ لَهَا طَلَبًا وَأَعْلَمَ فِيهَا رَغَبًا. The hadith continues, Allah will say to the angels, to the malaika, what are my servants asking me for? So the angels will say, by Allah, they're asking you for paradise, for Jannah. So then Allah will say to the angels, although He knows, did they see Jannah yet? Have they seen Jannah, this thing that they're desiring to go to, that they're asking for? The angels will say, Wallahi, no, by Allah, they have not seen Jannah. They have not seen it. So Allah then says, how would it be if they saw it? The angels say, if they saw it, they would have a greater covetousness for it. They would do way more. They would want it like they want everything they want in this dunya times 100. If they saw Jannah. And they would seek it with greater zeal. They would do whatever they had to do to get it, just like when they fight for a property or a piece of land or a home that they desire with their eyes in this dunya. And they would have a greater desire for it. We are living life as if Jannah is just a thought. But it is a reality. It has already been created by our Creator, and it will exist forever, eternally, and it will never go away. It will be there for all times. Use the descriptions Allah gave you to draw a map of that, instead of just flipping through magazines and Google and all this other stuff to see where should I go on my next vacation. Maybe that's why we follow our desires and we chase this dunya and we're so proud and arrogant with what we're achieving here. Allah says, وَأُزْلِفَتِ الْجَنَّةُ لِلْمُتَّقِينَ غَيْرَ بَعِيدٍ. And paradise will be brought forth for the muttaqun, for those who kept their duty to Allah, for those who struggled for Allah, for those who did everything they could to obey Allah and His Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam according to the authentic sunnah. So they could put between themselves and Allah a barrier to protect themselves between from Allah's punishment. This is the muttaqun, the righteous ones, the pious ones. Paradise will be brought near to them. هذا ما توعدون لكل أواب حفيظ. It will be said, this is the Jannah that you were promised. These are the gardens that we informed you of that you would get as a reward if you worship me alone without any partners. It is for those offered turning and sincere repentance. For those who they sin. Allah didn't say it's for the sinless. He said it's for those who are returning in repentance, seeking tawbah, making tawbah, seeking Allah's forgiveness left and right. And those who preserve their covenant to Allah by obeying Him with what He ordered, worshipping none but Him, being firm upon tawheed, even if the people mock you, even if the people desert you, even if it's your own family, that you're firm upon that. And following the sunnah of His Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. مَنْ خَشِيَ الرَّحْمَنَ بِالْغَيْبِ وَجَاءَ بِقَلْبٍ مُنِيبٍ. Who feared the Most Beneficent, who feared Allah in the ghaib, who fear the most beneficent Allah in the ghaib and unseen, in this worldly life before seeing him and meeting him. And he brought to Allah a heart that was turned in repentance to him. أدخلوها بسلام. Enter this Jannah in peace and security. ذلك يوم الخلود. This is the day of eternal life. Because if we make it to Jannah, then that is forever being young, not sick, not sad, not depressed, not anxious, not ill. No death for eternity. ذلك يوم الخلود, the day of eternal life. لهم ما يشاءون فيها ولدينا مزيد. They will have all that they desire. Having all you desire in this Jannah, if it's all coming to you, in this dunya, if that's what's coming to you, fear Allah. That may not be a blessing. Because having all that you desire is a play, is something that is given to the people of Jannah, who will be given Jannah. They will have all that they desire, and then we will have more for them, being able to look at the face of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. مثل الجنة التي وعد المتقون. The description of paradise which the muttaqun have been promised. فيها أنهار من ماء غير آسن وأنهار من لبن لم يتغير طعمه وأنهار من خمر لذة للشاربين وأنهار من عسل مصفى ولهم فيها من كل الثمرات ومغفرة من ربهم. The description of paradise from the muttaqun, what they've been promised. Rivers of water, pure to the taste, it will never change. Rivers of milk, pure, it will never go bad. It will taste perfect to you and quench your thirst. And it will never be changed. Rivers of wine that are delicious to those who drink it without intoxicating them. Rivers of clarified and pure honey, clear and pure. Therein for them is every kind of fruit. And more importantly, forgiveness from their Lord. That they'll be forgiven for their sins and be admitted into this Jannah forever. Are these like those who shall dwell in the hellfire and be given to drink boiling water that will cut up their intestines? Which do you desire? This is for the muttaqun. This is Jannah. Its tents, like a concealed pearl 60 miles long. The shade of its trees, you could ride as a fast rider for 100 years and you'll still be in the shade of that one tree. The tree trunks are made of gold and silver. Its fruits are softer than butter and sweeter than honey. Its food, fruits from whatever you choose, and the meat of whatever birds you desire. جَنَّاتُ عَدْنٍ يَدْخُلُونَهَا يُحَلُّونَ فِيهَا مِنْ أَسَاوَرَ مِنْ ذَهَبٍ وَلُؤْلُؤَ وَلِبَاسُهُمْ فِيهَا حَرِيرٌ. Adan, paradise, everlasting gardens, will they enter therein? Will they be adorned with bracelets of gold and pearls, and their garments there will be silk? So a reminder to my brothers in Islam, because silk and gold are permitted for the women but not for the men. Because for the men, the reward for them abstaining from that, and instead of indulging in the luxury of silk and gold in this dunya, is that she will be given this as furnishings in Jannah, bi-ibnillahi ta'ala. So it is not proper that the man wears any jewelry other than a ring that is silver or platinum or titanium. It cannot be gold, not white gold, not yellow gold. And silk, harir, is forbidden for the men in this dunya as well. Leave it off in this life so you'll be getting it in Jannah bi-ibnillahi ta'ala. Mu'ad ibn Jabir radiallahu anhu, he mentioned that the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, whoever fasts Ramadan and performs the salah and makes hajj to the house, and he said, I can't remember if zakat was mentioned or not. He said, whoever does this, he does it except that it is binding on Allah that he forgive him, whether he immigrated in the cause of Allah or he remained in the land in which he was born. Mu'ad radiallahu anhu, he said, should I inform the people of this? The Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, ذَرِ النَّاسَ يَعْمَلُونَ فَإِنَّ فِي الْجَنَّةِ مِئَةَ دَرَجَةٍ مَا بَيْنَ كُلِّ دَرَجَتَيْنِ كَمَا بَيْنَ السَّمَاءِ وَالْأَرْضِ وَالْفِرْدَوْسُ أَعْلَى الْجَنَّةِ وَأَوْسَطُهَا وَفَوْقَ ذَلِكَ عَرْشُ الرَّحْمَنِ وَمِنْهَا تُفَجَّرُ أَنْهَارُ الْجَنَّةِ فَإِذَا سَأَلْتُمُ اللَّهَ فَسَلُوهُ الْفِرْدَوْسُ. رواه الترمذي. In this hadith, which is sahih, the Prophet ﷺ, he concluded it saying, leave the people to do good deeds. Tell them to keep doing good and more good and more good, for verily in paradise there is 100 levels. Don't just aim to get 2 feet in there. Go for the higher levels. There's 100 levels in Jannah. Between every level of Jannah is like the distance between the heavens and the earth. And Firdaus is the highest of paradise, and it's most expansive. And above it, its roof is Arsh al-Rahman. It is the throne of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the most merciful. And from it, all of the rivers of paradise flow forth. So when you ask Allah for Jannah, ask Him for al-Firdaus, the highest of it. So let us make sure that we're asking Allah in this way. قال فمما يتعوذون قال يقولون من النار قال يقول وهل رأوها قال يقولون لا والله ما رأوها قال يقول فكيف لو رأوها قال يقولون لو رأوها كانوا أشد منها فرارا وأشد لها مخافة. Allah then says in this continuing hadith that the Prophet ﷺ gave us, Allah will say, from what do these people doing the dhikr in the roads and the turq that the angels saw and went and reported to Allah? He said, what are they seeking refuge from? The angels will say they seek refuge from Jahannam, from going to the hellfire. Allah says, did they see it? He'll say, no, wallahi, my Lord, they did not see it. By Allah, they did not see it. They did not see it. Allah says, how would it have been if they saw it? The angels say, if they saw it, they would flee from it. Like an extreme fear. They would run fast and do everything they could do to get away from it. And they would have extreme fear from it. Ikhwani wa akhwati fillah, we're constantly warned of this. فَإِن لَمْ تَفْعَلُوا وَلَمْ تَفْعَلُوا فَاتَّقُوا النَّارَ الَّتِي وَقُودُهَا النَّاسُ وَالْحِجَارَةُ أُعِدَّتْ لِلْكَافِرِينَ. But if they do not, and you can never, and, but if you do it not, and you can never do it, then fear the fire, whose fuel is men and stones prepared for the disbelievers. Going there should be feared. Just like you would fear to run into a burning building in this life. Or to run into an enclosure that had hyenas and lions and tigers. This is the way you should flee from such a thing as Jahannam. Again, my brothers and sisters in Islam, paradise and Jahannam, they are true. They are both already created. Paradise is situated in the seventh heaven under the roof of Ar-Rahman, and the fire is beneath the seventh earth. And they're both already created. And Allah knows the number that will enter Jannah and the number that will enter Jahannam. And Abi Hurairah radiallahu anhu قال رسول الله عفوا. He said, كان مع رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم إذ سمع وجبة فقال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم تدرون ما هذا قالوا قلنا قال قلنا الله ورسوله أعلم قال هذا حجر رمي به في النار منذ 70 خريفة فهو يهوي في النار الآن حتى انتهى إلى قعرها رواه مسلم. The companions were in the company of the Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم and they heard a terrible sound. So the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said, تدرون ما هذا, do you know what this sound was? They said, Allah and His Messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم know best. He said, this was a stone that was thrown 70 years before into the hellfire, and it's been constantly falling until it has just reached its base. If you go to the Grand Canyon and you throw a stone, it will reach the bottom of it before you even know it, even though it looks like such a far distance. This is how deep the hellfire is. You don't think it's created already? Then what about this hadith Abu Hurairah narrated, where he said the Messenger of Allah صلى الله عليه وسلم said, أشتكت النار إلى ربها فقالت ربي أكل بعض بعضا. That the hellfire, Jahannam, complained to its Lord, oh my Lord, parts of me have eaten other parts of me up. فأذن لها بنفسين, نفس في الشتاء ونفس في الصيف, فأشد ما تجدون في الحرب وأشد ما تجدون من الزمهرير. رواه البخاري. So the Prophet ﷺ, he said, so Allah allowed Jahannam to take two breaths, one in the winter and one in the summer. And this is the reason for the severe heat in the winter. And it is the reason for the bitter cold, the zamharir, that cold that burns you because it's so cold. This is the reason for the bitter cold of the winter, weather. Can you doubt that Jahannam is already created and raging and burning and fueled? It's just waiting for mankind and stones to fuel it more. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he said, قَالَ قَرِينُهُ رَبَّنَا مَا أَطْغَيْتُ وَلَكِنْ كَانَ فِي ضَلَالٍ بَعِيدٍ. His companion, his devilish companion, will say, our Lord, I did not push him to sin or to transgress, But he was himself in error far astray. قال لا تصنوا لدي وقد قدمت إليكم بالوعيد. Allah will say, dispute not in front of me. I had already in advance set you a threat. I sent you the threat that this would be your abode if you transgressed and did evil and disbelieved. ما يبدل القول لدي وما أنا بظلام للعبيد. The sentence that comes from me will never be changed. And I cannot do any injustice to my slaves. I do not do any injustice to them. يوم نقول لجهنم هل امتلأت وتقول هل من مزيد. On that day, we will say to Jahannam, are you filled? Have you had enough? And Jahannam will say, are there any more to come? Because it has room. This is a Jahannam, a hellfire that will be drawn out yawm al-qiyamah. 70,000 chains. On every chain of the 70,000 will be 70,000 angels. Do the math of how many angels that is just to bring Jahannam forth for the people to see it. This is a hellfire that one drop of it, if it landed in this earth, it would scorch the whole earth. Bottom, down, up, down, right, left, the whole earth, one drop of its boiling water. عَلَيْهَا تِسْعَةَ عَشَرَ Garden Jahannam is 19 angels. Its gatekeeper being Malik, the angel Malik, guarding it. It will be asked, you have enough, and it will say, do you have any more? May Allah protect us from it. أَقُولَ فَلِهَذَا وَاسْتَغْفِرَ اللَّهِ وَلَكُمْ أَدْعُوا اللَّهَ يَغْفِرْ لَكُمْ ذُنُوبَكُمْ. إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونستهديه ونصلي ونسلم على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم تسليما كثيرا وبعد. My dear brothers and sisters in Islam, these ahadith should wrap our hearts and make us want to change. What did it start with? That the angels will encircle and cover, their wings will cover up to the skies of this dunya around the people who study the deen of Allah. Remember Allah, glorify Allah, make takbir and tahmid and tahleel and tasbih. Study. Come to the masajid to study, to learn so you know your deen, so you can answer properly in the grave. What's the reward? Allah, He will reward you with being able to see His face. Allah, He will reward you with Jannah, بإذن الله تعالى, even though you don't see it, you're asking for it. Allah, He will protect you from the hellfire if you ask Him to protect you from it. Why? And He'll forgive your sins. The hadith continues, قَالَ فَيَقُولُ فَأُشْهِدُكُمْ أَنِّي قَدْ غَفَرْتُ لَهُمْ. قَالَ يَقُولُ مَلَكٌ مِنَ الْمَلَائِكَةِ فِيهِمْ فُلَانٌ لَيْسَ مِنْهُمْ إِنَّمَا جَاءَ لِحَاجَةٍ. قَالَ هُمْ الْجُلَسَاءُ لَا يَشْقَى بِهِمْ جَلِيسُهُمْ. رواه البخاري. Look at how merciful your Lord is. One of the angels, Afan, Allah, He says, I make you witnesses to those angels that I will forgive them. That I have forgiven them, these people who study, seeking Jannah, seeking to see Allah's face and to be saved from that hellfire. He said, you are witnesses that I have forgiven them. So Allah's Messenger, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, one of the angels will say, there was so-and-so amongst them. He's not normally amongst them, but he just stopped by for a need. Maybe he was traveling, he had to stop by in here. Or maybe he came to meet a brother because he had to give him something. Right? So the angel says he came for that reason. Allah would say, these are those people whose companions will not be reduced to misery. رواه البخاري. These are the companions, meaning the person in Allah's rahmah who came and just was there for a need because he was around those people. If Allah said He would forgive that group, then that person who came and just stopped for his need would also be forgiven. لا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله. There is no power or might except with Allah. My dear brothers and sisters in Islam, I leave you with this. The hadith of Ubadah where he said that the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, من شهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأن محمد عبده ورسوله وأن عيسى عبده عبد الله ورسوله وكلمته ألقاها إلى مريم وروح منه والجنة حق والنار حق أدخله الله الجنة على ما كان من العمل. And in another narration زاد من أبواب الجنة الثمانية أيها يشاء أيها شاء. رواه البخاري. We'll end by this. Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم, he said in authentic hadith, if anyone testifies that there is no one, no person, no thing, no deity, no object worthy of worship in truth except for Allah alone without partners, and that Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam is his slave and his messenger, and that Jesus alayhi salam is his slave and his messenger, and his word which he bestowed on Mary, and a spirit created by him, and that paradise, Jannah, is true and already existing, and Jahannam is true, the hellfire is true and already existing, Allah will admit him into paradise with the deeds which he has done, even if those deeds were little. And in another narration he adds, such a person can enter paradise through any of the 8 gates that he likes. My dear brothers and sisters in Islam, keep your tongues wet with the remembrance of Allah. Come to the halaqat, come to the durus, come to the lessons to learn your deen and make your deen firm upon what you believe, especially in the doors of tawheed and aqeedah. Learn your deen. Shove your pride aside and culture aside and everything else that might be clouding your eyes and your memory or your thoughts. And come to the Quran and the Sunnah. Believe in them. Jannah is created already. Jahannam is created already. That any time you complain of the heat or the severe cold, it's a proof that Jahannam is already there. May Allah make us of those who are admitted to Jannah and saved from the hellfire, and those who get to see the face of Allah يوم القيامة as believers and in Jannah بإذن الله تعالى. اللهم اغفر للمسلمين والمسلمات والمؤمنين والمؤمنات الأحياء منهم والأموات إنك أنت السميع القريب المجيب الدعوات يا مقلب القلوب ثبت قلوبنا على دينك. اللهم ادخلنا الجنة الفردوس الأعلى. اللهم ادخلنا الجنة الفردوس الأعلى. اللهم ادخلنا الجنة الفردوس الأعلى. اللهم أجرنا من النار. اللهم أجرنا من النار. اللهم أجرنا من النار برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين. سبحان ربك رب العزة أما يصفون وسلام على المرسلين والحمد لله رب العالمين وصلى الله على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين.